अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। आई वेलकम ऑल सेमिस्टर वन स्टूडेंट्स टू श्री चंद्रास डिस्टेंस लर्निंग प्रोग्राम। दिस हैज़ बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड ड्यू टू दिस ऑनगोइंग पैंडेमिक C19। What is our agenda today? Our today's agenda is, first we will take a review of the previous class, then we will proceed towards next topic. Okay, first we will take the review of the previous class, then we will discuss about the subject, introduction to subject. Okay. Just a moment. Okay. Right, we were discussing about the introduction to syllabus. Okay. First, we will take the review of the previous class. What we were studying in our last class, we had taken the introduction of the language. What is language? What is language? Language is a source of communication between people. Okay, language has derived from the Latin word lingua, which means tongue, zuban. There are more than 6,000 languages spoken all over the world. Among those 6,000 languages, nearly 3,000 languages has grasped the position of a language. Okay, among those 3,000 languages, only 20 languages are there which are spoken all over the world. And the UNO has selected 6 languages for communication. What are those 6 languages? Among those 6 languages, Arabic is one of them. Okay. So yesterday we were discussing about the importance of Arabic language. What is the importance of Arabic language? Arabic is a language of Quran. Arabic is the language of prophetic traditions. Arabic is the language of paradise. And Arabic is the language of worship. It is an international global language. It is the national language of 22 countries. It is the religious language of more than 56 countries. Okay, this is the importance. If we want to become a global citizen, then we must know 4 languages. Those are Arabic, English, and French, Spanish. Spanish is there. Okay, if we master over these 4 languages, then we can survive anywhere in the world. So Arabic is one of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen Arabic for his last divine scripture. Okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for his last divine scripture. And the Prophet of Allah said, love Arabic for 3 reasons. Your Quran is in Arabic. Your prophet is Arabian, and your language in the paradise will be Arabic. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ahibb al arabiyya min thalathin. Love Arabic for 3 reasons. Quranuka arabi, your Quran is in Arabic. The glorious Quran, word of Allah, is in Arabic language. Wa rasuluka arabi, and your prophet is an Arabian. And last one is lisanuka fil jannah arabi, and Arabic will be the language of paradise. When we go to paradise, only Arabic language will be spoken there in the paradise. Okay, this was the short. One more thing. Arabic is the language of worship. when we worship, we recite many things in Arabic in the prayer. Other than Arabic, if we recite in Urdu or any other language, no prayer will be accepted. For example, Salah, Namaz. In the Salah, we used to recite Surah Al-Fatiha in Arabic, then Dhamma Al-Surah, Dhamma Al-Surah in Arabic, and the Tasbih of Ruku in Arabic, and Tasbih of Sajda in Arabic. All these are in Arabic language. Tashahud is in Arabic. If anyone recite these all obligatory, compulsory recitings in other language, his prayer will not be accepted. So Arabic is considered as a language of worship. And it has not confined to the Arab world. It has spread all over the world because due to the spread of Islam, due to the expansion of Islamic states at that time, now the Arabic has not only the property and whole and soul of Arab world, but it has become the property of all Muslim community, Muslim Ummah. Whosoever embrace Islam, he learns Arabic because he want to understand the Quran. And the divine scripture, the last scripture of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in Arabic. If anyone want to understand prophetic tradition, he must learn Arabic to understand the prophetic traditions. And also, the prophetic traditions are also in Arabic. The Prophet of Allah, whatever said, he said in Arabic. If we want to understand the correct and true meaning of prophetic traditions, then we must learn Arabic so that to understand the actual meaning. Okay, so that to understand its actual meaning. And also, there are more than 50 lakh words. There are more than 50 lakh words in Arabic. So it denotes the vocabulary of Arabic. Arabic has a large vocabulary. Arabic has a very large vocabulary. Okay. This was our previous class. Now we will take the introduction to syllabus. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Introduction to syllabus. Yesterday I have given a brief introduction regarding syllabus, about syllabus. Today we will go in the depth. Okay. We will go a bit deep in the syllabus today. Yesterday, brief introduction was given. Today, we will learn a bit in depth. Introduction to syllabus. So, in your syllabus, introduction to syllabus for SEM 1 students. For semester 1, BCom, BSc, and BCom General, BBA, BA, etc. All have the same similar language, SEM 1. Introduction to syllabus for semester 1 students. Reader. One reader is there in your syllabus, namely Al-Qiraat, Al-Qiraat, Al-Arabi, Al-Usmaniya, Al-Qiraat, Al-Arabiya, Al-Arabiya, Al-Usmaniya. This is the name of your reader, Al-Qiraat, Al-Arabiya, Al-Usmaniya. In this reader, you have 4 units. Throughout the semester, we have to learn about these 4 units. We have to study these 4 units. Unit first. Unit first belongs to classical prose. Okay. Unit first belongs to classical prose. Unit first belongs to classical prose. And it contains two lessons. Okay. Unit first belongs to classical prose. It contains two lessons. That is Sura, Alam Nashra, Sura Alam Nashra and Sura At-Teen. Okay, these two surahs we are going to study. Okay, now take the blueprint as well. From this classical prose, LAQ, one LAQ will be asked and one SAQ will be asked. Short answer type question and long answer type questions. For short answer type, one question will be asked for 5 marks. And for long answer type, one question will be asked for 15 marks. So total 20 marks paper will be covered from unit first. Now come to unit second. Unit second belongs to modern prose. Okay, unit first. Al-Wahda Ula, Al-Wahdatul Ula, Classical Pro, Al-Nasrul Qadim, Quranul Majid, Suratu Alam Nashra and Suratu Teen. Two surahs are there in unit first. And in, as far as the modern prose is concerned, second unit modern prose, it also contains two lessons, namely Al-Hiwar. Al-Hiwar. Conversation and An-Nazafa. An-Nazafa. Cleanliness. Conversation, cleanliness. Two lessons are there in say, modern prose. And same thing, one SAQ will be asked for 5 marks and one LAQ will be asked for 15 marks. From this second unit. So total 20 marks paper will be covered from modern prose. Are you following? Yes. Now come to unit number 3. Unit number 3 belongs to grammar. Al-Qawaid al-Arabiya. Grammar. And it also contains two lessons. Lesson number one, word and its kinds. Al-Kalimatu wa Aqsamuha, its kinds. Al-Kalimatu wa Aqsamuha. And second one, Al-Ismu wa Aqsamuhu, noun and its kinds. Noun and its kinds. Same thing. From unit third, 5 marks for SAQs and 15 marks for LAQs. So total 20 marks paper will be covered from unit third. Got it? Now capture the screenshot. Capture the screenshot, please. Later, you may copy it down in your notebook. Capture the screenshot. Taken? Because I am going to rub the board. Capture the screenshot. Okay, now unit 4. Unit 4 belongs to history of Arabic literature. History of Arabic literature. In this unit, you have three lessons. Lesson number one, features of Arabic language. Features of Arabic language. And lesson number two, poetry and poets in pre-Islamic period. Pre-Islamic time. Okay. Here you may see, here I am writing fourth unit, this side. This is your fourth unit. Fourth unit belongs to History of Arabic Literature, Mizatul Lughatil Arabiya, first lesson, Poetry and Poets. Poetry and poets in pre-Islamic time or period, Ash-Shi'ru wa Shu'ara'u fi Asri al-Jahili. Then last lesson, lesson number three. Only fourth unit contains three lessons. Al-Mu'allaqatu Sab'ah, the seven prize-winning poems. The seven prize-winning poems. Al-Mu'allaqatu Sab'atu, the seven prize-winning poems are the seven suspended. The seven suspended, the seven hangings. Okay, this is your fourth unit. From fourth unit also, for SAQ, one question will be asked, five for 5 marks, and for LAQ, 15 marks. So total 20 marks paper will be covered from unit 4. In this way, the total paper will be covered of 80 marks. 20 marks for SAQs and 60 marks for LAQs. In this way, the total becomes 80. Okay, 20 plus 60. 60 for LAQs and 24 SAQs, short answer type questions. Now, remaining 20 marks for internal exams. Internal assessment one, internal assessment one and two. Two internal assessment will be conducted, sorry, only internal assessment one. For one internal assessment, you will get 15 marks. And for project, topic will be given. You have to submit the project. The project contains 5 marks. In this way, the total reaches to 100. Got it? Internal assessment 1, 80 marks. Internal assessment 1 will be of 15 marks and project contains 5 marks. Okay. In this way, the total reaches to 100. Got it? Take the screenshot. Now, I shall rub this board. I think you have taken the screenshot. Now come to paper pattern. paper pattern. What will be the paper pattern? So in paper pattern, from section A, you have two sections. Section A, 4 × 5 is equal to 20 marks. Here, you have to answer 4 questions out of 6. So, 4 out of 6. 6 questions. So 2 questions will be there in choice. 4 × 5 is equal to 20 marks. So section A contains 6 questions. From among 6 questions, from 6 questions, you have to answer 4 questions. Each carries 5 marks. Then section B. Section B is of long answer type question. Section A is of short answer type questions. And section B is for long answer type questions. Here, 4 × 15 is equal to 60 marks. 4 × 15 is equal to 60. 60 marks paper will be asked from all the 4 units. Each carries 15 marks. In this way, 80 marks paper is covered. This is your external exam. External exam. For external exam, you have 80 marks. Now come to internal. Internal, one internal assessment exam will be conducted and carries 15 marks. And for project, the topic will be provided, given, will be given for 5 marks. In this way, you will get total 100 marks. What will be the minimum passing marks for all these from 100 marks? The minimum passing marks are 40. If you get 40 marks, then you will be declared as pass. Then that is passing marks. 40 marks is the minimum criteria to score. And if you score more than 40, then grades will be given. Okay. If you go below 40, then F will be indicated as failed, detained candidate. Okay. You may capture the screenshot. Capture the screenshot and later you may copy it down in your notebook. Now we are proceeding towards the syllabus. First we will start from section grammar. Okay. From easy to the hard. जी नहीं नहीं माशाल्लाह अच्छा नेटवर्क भी अच्छा आ रहा और ये स्टैंड भी आ गया. दिस इज योर पेपर पैटर्न. सेक्शन ए कैरीज 20 मार्क्स. यू हैव टू आंसर 4 questions out of 6 questions. एंड सेक्शन बी कैरीज 60 मार्क्स. Here you have choice of internal choice. With internal choice, with internal choice means 2 questions will be given from each unit. You have to answer this or that. From second unit, 2 questions will be given and you have to answer this or that, this one or that one. And from third unit as well, then fourth unit also. Got it? Capture the screenshot, then we will proceed towards the next lesson. very good doubt. Here you can see that in section B there will be 8 questions. Actually 4 questions from each unit, 2 questions will be given, and choice will be given as internal choice. Okay, from two questions you have to answer one. From unit first, 2 questions will be given, you have to answer one question. From unit second, 2 questions will be given, you have to answer one question. From unit third, 2 questions, one should be answered. And from unit fifth, 2 questions will be given, one should be answered. Got it? 4 into 15, 60. 15 marks for internal, 5 marks for project. In this way, you will reach to 100. More than 85 marks will be considered as the merit student. Outstanding performance. More than 85 marks. 85 or more than 85. Grades will be provided as O, A, B, C, D, E. Okay. This is above 85%. This is up to 40%. Below 40 will be F. Okay. About 50% marks, 55%, 65%, 75%. Okay. If you score above 85% marks, then you will be awarded O grade. O grade will be awarded. And if you score 75% marks or more than 75 up to 84%, then you will be provided A grade. Then B grade up to 65 below 75% marks. C grade for below 60, above say 55 and below 64. Then D grade is up to 50. Below 54%, and E grade is for gaining 40% or 49% marks. Then if you fall down from 40% marks, then the result will be F. Then you have to repeat the exam. Okay. With this we will stop here. Let us take some interaction session.